Ladies and gentlemen, today we got ourselves a new Marvel Legends wave. Today, I am coming to you guys. Well, hello, Barack the Collector here, sorry. I am just so excited to be coming to you guys with the Marvel Legends Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmo the Build-A-Figure wave video. These are hitting Walmarts. This is currently the 31st. I got these on Wednesday, and they're hitting Walmarts around the United States. So, you know, if you're out there, go check up on them. This wave should be out of there pretty soon. These are the first Marvel Legends I have picked up. The first new Marvel Legends I picked up this year. The last new Marvel Legend I got was the Eric Killmonger What If figure. So, yeah, man, I've been in a drought, and I am so excited to open these. We're just gonna dive right into it. Let's start with Star-Lord first, then I'll get you guys out of this BS camera angle that we're in. As you can see, this wave, I don't feel like any figure this year is gonna be coming out in the standard Marvel Legends packaging. I feel like everything's gonna be plastic-free from now on, so, I mean, this is just kind of the norm. I don't really care about that sort of thing too much. It would've nice to been seen what these would've looked like in the regular packaging, the good old window boxes, but hey, it's Star-Lord, man. The figure's still in there. Let's take a look. Real quickly, before we get into the wave, though, I do just want to tell you guys, just before we start the video, in case you haven't noticed, I am trying a new style of video today. After receiving a comment on my Black Panther wave a few months ago, the Black Panther wave video, somebody had said that, like, they feel like my reviews are, especially my reviews on, you know, actual waves, kind of feel handicapped from time to time because I'll show you them in the display with the context of other characters, but I won't really get to, you know, take them down and show you the figures in depth. So I figured, hey, you know what? I do kind of already do that with some of my single release figures and exclusives. Let's try it with the wave. So we're going to be taking a look at all these guys individually, and then after we're done, I'll plop them onto the shelf and we'll take a look at them in the context of some other characters. But let's try this, because now we can actually get out some comparisons. I can show you guys some side-by-sides. And we can get it popping with this wave, because these are a lot of characters that we have gotten before, and I bet that y'all want to see those comparisons. So let's get into it. All right, actually. Okay, you see, this figure is the figure in the wave that you kind of take at face value, because yes, this figure comes with nothing. Like, right, open the box, right? And this is his accessory bag, which are his two blasters, and this is the bag that he comes with. Figure-wise, this is already something that you probably have a good amount of if you have any Marvel Legends Star-Lord that was made in recent history. You got pieces here from different Star-Lords. So you got the arms, which are adopted from the Guardians of the Galaxy, the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 version. Those are new up until about the shoulders, which are a whole different piece that, you know, more align with the actual costume that we're taking a look at here. You got the legs, which are also the Guardians of the Galaxy 2 legs. These are basically the only Star-Lord legs we've ever had in the line, except for the 2014 Star-Lord, but that figure's not that great. So these are, if you have only the good Star-Lord figures, you've always had the same Star-Lord legs, no matter which one it is. If it's accurate to the costume, if you're asking me, I'm not really sure. I know that there's some things on the costume that, like, as terms of paint that are here, or that aren't here, that are there. For example, there's like a red stripe that's supposed to go down right there. You got that on this side. That's for all of them, I think, don't have that. There's like another black line that's supposed to go down here, I think. As far as the back goes, you do see some texture detail, so that might be right as far as I know. I'm not really sure. This black strap around the arm is accurate, to be fair. You got the nice, the beautiful looking Ravager symbol there on the chest. Is it a Ravager symbol or a Guardian symbol? I guess they're kind of folded into each other. I'm not really sure about the differences. Up here towards the face, this is where the figure really shines. That is the best Chris Pratt head sculpt we've ever gotten. My thumbnail is long. I have not cut it my right thumbnail. Whatever. That Chris Pratt head sculpt is amazing right there. Are y'all seeing that? Now, I think that they've done really good Chris Pratt head sculpts before. I've seen them do good ones. Like the two-pack that came with Ego, that head sculpt was kind of shiny, but it was good regardless. Like, that was a really good Chris Pratt head sculpt. I think that was the first one that actually utilized the photoreal tech very well. But you can see there, you can even see the eyes slightly blue. You can see the pink of the lips. Like, it looks really good. It's not shiny like other photoreal is. Trust me, like, in person, this looks delicious. You know, not saying that like I want to eat Chris Pratt or whatever. I'm just, the detail is delicious. Excuse me. But yeah, let's whip out this figure with some comparisons for real. It's not like it's been a while since we've had Star-Lord, but whew, man, this Guardians Wave feels so good. It's like nourishing me because it has been 6 years since we got the last Guardians of the Galaxy Wave. So we actually got some new sculpts going on here. Star-Lord is not one of the 100% completely new sculpts, of course, but there are highlights to this figure that will pop up in some of these comparisons. Number one, look, when this head sculpt came out, I was kind of defending it. I didn't think it looked awful, but really, yeah, that does look way more like Ego than it does Chris Pratt. Like, that does not look like Star-Lord. That does not look like Chris Pratt. Hold on, let me get y'all a zoom in. Zoom in view. You guys see that? So, I formally apologize. Those people who were saying that it looks awful, you guys are probably just at a future prospective vision, and you were able to see this in the future, and you were just like, yeah, I know what's coming, so this looks like absolute trash. They will do a lot better, and they have, so yeah. So this is the Volume 2 head that came with the 2-pack Star-Lord, and after selling you this, I can tell you that the ball peg on this head is big. It's not too big to allow it to fit, but if you're going to switch any other Star-Lord head onto this figure, I would highly recommend heating it up before you switch it out. Vice versa, though, this head fits onto this figure just fine. I mean, this is the... I think that's... What head sculpt is that? That's gotta be the Cosmic Rewind head sculpt that came in that Cosmic Rewind set from last year. And if you wanted to put this new head up on there, then it works just fine. Yeah, it looks pretty good and everything. I'd say it looks a lot better than the Love and Thunder head. So, but yeah, Star-Lord, not the most inspiring figure, but a fantastic head sculpt that just goes to show how far photoreal has come. Let's go to Mantis next. Cosmo Leg, we'll go into that later. Mantis! So for a brief time here, this figure, when I was unwrapping it, had me thinking that I was colorblind, because in all of the promo shots that I had seen of it, I was thinking that her hair was going to be black, but they've incorporated this very much looking like this green almost tint here that I really have never, ever, ever noticed. And I'm pretty sure I've seen close-up images of this before. But if you look at the box art here, you can see the green. Like, Mantis does have little green streaks in her hair like that, which I am just now noticing. They did actually generate an all-new woman body to use for the woman figures in this wave, for the female figures, I guess, since not all of them are human women. But here we got a very nice body, in a sense. As you can see, coming down from the boots here, the legs, we got boots here. Usually with boots, like for Gamora and them, they don't incorporate ankle pivot, at least historically, but these boots have a very nice ankle pivot here that you can see. You can get all different types of very, you know, dynamic poses out of it. You got this beautiful, beautiful pinless leg here. I know that some people feel like pinless is a bit overrated. Like, you know, I really treat it like it's the greatest thing ever, but really, I do feel like it is. It makes the leg very stiff, makes it very nice. You know, usually when posing, especially with figures whether you want to put into running poses, whenever it has pins in the leg, you know, the connection there is a lot less stable. But in legs like these, they just feel so nice. Yeah. Yep, that is a beautiful joint right there. Good job on that. You got actual texturing in here towards the leg that if I bring you guys in close like here, you can actually see. You got the red streak going down into the leg here. All of these costumes are a bit too bright blue, but they do work costume-wise. It's not like the promo shots make them look like they're really, really bright blue, but they're just sort of more like a almost deep blue, almost, but they're not a super-duper light blue. So they're fine looking. They look pretty good. Coming up to the chest, you can see she has a very similar belt to Star-Lord. You can see this very nice, this is sort of a design hallmark in these new Guardian suits, but you can see like a weird curve line that goes down up into the suit, almost like a flap for a strap or something. Coming up into the chest, you can again see very nicely painted Guardians logo. Arms, you can see the black stripe that is another aspect of these matching outfits. Going over to the deeper in the arms, you can see nice pinless joint here that can get some great range. Oh wow, is that better than Nakia? That might be, that just might be better than Nakia. Like, that's some of the farthest I've seen. It's just so nice. I always, you know, if you guys were just getting into Marvel Legends 2021 or whatever, you guys have no idea the reality that we were living in the past when it comes to the figures for the girls. Like, honestly, they were nowhere near this good. Coming in towards the back, you have very nice detail in there, some more lines and textures. But that head sculpt is the true sign. You can see Pomplimentif. Now, people, I've noticed people saying something about the eyes. Yeah, the eyes look sort of weird. Now, here's the thing. It's not like Mantis's eyes are completely black. You will be able to see some white towards the sides. And there are some scenes that I see that this represents that just fine. But these eyes can almost look regular. Like, you can see some brown in those eyes. And I really just don't feel like Mantis's eyes have any color in them at all. I'm betting that y'all are thinking that I would be pretty crazy not to compare her to her old figure. Now, when you have them like this, whew, this Mantis is tall, man. So they're both in relatively, like, their legs are both relatively spread out. This Mantis is sort of an illusion that she's playing on you guys, since she's sort of, you know, curving, arcing forward her body a little bit. She's going to appear shorter. I can understand that. But this figure is definitely taller. And I guess that they tried to use a proportion somewhere in the middle, because I'm pretty sure that Karen Gillan is taller than her by a few inches. But yeah, the figure is tall. If you don't have them together, you're not really going to notice that well. But it's a tall Mantis. She's not that tall. She's not that tall. She's not the same height as Chris Pratt or around there. At least I don't think. At least not up to the top of the head. Chris Pratt is taller here, but yeah, no, I don't think that got it 100%. Like, so yeah, proportionality and accuracies like that. But that's something that if you're a Marvel Legends collector, an MCU collector especially, you're used to. So yeah. But all in all, if you want to try a head sculpt between this Mantis and this one, it works just fine. It's the same head sculpt, or a similar head sculpt, you know. So yeah, it's the same head sculpt. It'll work fine. Oh man, it feels so nice to open a Guardians of the Galaxy wave. I'm not like a traditional reviewer. I don't usually do this. So if you guys are liking this format of the video for, you know, wave reviews and wave breakdowns, stuff like that, I hate to call my stuff reviews because I've never really associated myself as a reviewer in the traditional sense of the word. But if you guys are enjoying this format of video for Marvel Legends waves, let me know and I'll keep doing it, because I do like to be able to give you guys a closer look at the figure like this, so that, you know, you guys don't just have to take what I'm saying at face value, so that you guys can actually see what I'm talking about. So, okay, this figure is fire. This is probably the figure in the wave, one of the figures in the wave that I was most looking forward to, because Nebula, believe it or not, is probably my favorite, probably my second favorite Guardians of the Galaxy character. You know, getting to see Nebula's, her character arc, it's so subtle throughout all of the movies that she's been in that you'd hardly notice it if you weren't paying attention. But also, it becomes apparent to you when you see where she ends up. It's that, like, she starts off, like, well, I'm not going to go into her whole life story. But anyways, her detail, her character work as both a friend of the Guardians, as well as whether she's a foe of the Guardians, a friend of the Guardians, or a Guardian herself, I just think is amazing. The fact that, you know, she finds family, because family is really all that she has left. She's had so much taken from her physically and mentally that, you know, the Guardians are kind of the last holdout of normalcy that she has, the last sort of teeny bit of happiness. And even whenever she walks away from them, she always comes back to them. And now that she's joined him, it's sort of representative of all that she's learned, and, you know, all that she loves. Anyways, that's besides the point. I'm no movie reviewer. I'm no psychological analyst. All I know is that this figure is great. I'm not going to spend too much time on her because it's the same as the Mantis figure from the torso up. What you do got different, though, is this arm, which they, of course, they always do a nice texturing job on. She's the only figure in the wave that has any good amount of accessories. She still should have come with some more trigger finger hands. You only get trigger finger hand for the arm here. This other arm is more of like a, you know, relaxed hand, which I do like relaxed hands. I really do appreciate relaxed hands, but her regular hand should have had a trigger finger arm as well, especially when you give her two guns. Sometimes you want to have them dual wielding. Only figure in this wave that comes with anything that's even like an interchangeable hand, and that is her sword right here. her arm sword. It's kind of cool to know that pieces of her body are interchangeable. So, or pieces of her armor interchangeable. Sorry, although the body thing is actually kind of true if you really think about it. I mean, especially that Thanos. Thanos definitely thought the same thing. So you can have that going on. Wait, have I been calling her Mantis this whole time? Nebula. Have I been saying Mantis this whole time? Anyways, no, Nebula is what I'm talking about. You haven't had a lot of options for Nebula because you've had the Guardians of the Galaxy version, which was the first version, which wasn't bad. And then you've had this version, which is really freaking good. You've had the Endgame version, which is just the Quantum Realm suit that you could pop the Nebula head onto, which looks fine. But it's not like getting an actual Mantis hero. While a lot of people have had onto their wish list an Endgame Nebula, which I would definitely still want. But this version is really cool, to be fair. Let's get her next to some other figures. I've waited until now to compare the head sculpts with you guys because I do want to show you guys these three. So you got the Endgame version here, which is a really good head sculpt, but you never got the rest of the body to go with it. It always just felt weird, and this body wasn't accurate. So, you know, that one was kind of as they come. This version, all she came with was her blaster that all of the Mantises have come with, the same exact blaster. Here we got a really nice head sculpt on this version. Again, Mantis's eyes are more black than this. You can see she almost has almost regular looking eyes, but that looks good still. I really feel like this is my favorite Mantis, even looking at the detail in the face. I like how the textures around the eyes are like very deepening. It almost looks like you're looking into a real face for real, and that is just the benefit of photoreal. And then you have the first Mantis, which, though the eyes are correct, it looks more like a toy than most of them. Because, I mean, you don't have those sort of more realistic-looking textures around the face. And in terms of, like, the color. And it just is very shiny. And it all just comes out looking quite quite cartoonish with that first Mantis. Or quite, you know, just not very realistic. Oh, sorry about that. Not very realistic with that first Mantis. So, that first Nebula. Sorry, gosh, why can't I ever get... I say that she's one of my favorite Guardians and I can't get her name right, damn. Rocket is my favorite Guardians of the Galaxy member. He's my favorite Guardian. I absolutely love Bradley Cooper's portrayal as Rocket. Now, when it comes to the figure, though, this figure, even though I like it, it's not great. I don't like a lot of things about it. So, the critical point of contention when it came to this figure. This figure, in a sense, summarizes a lot of the issues that people have with this wave. The value for money. Hasbro needs to understand that to us collectors, we don't care about tooling costs. We don't care about pricing. We don't care about labor. When the figure is this much smaller than the regular standard figure in the wave, it should not be worth the same price unless you're going to make it worth the same price. And by that, I mean, you gotta chunk this guy full of accessories. It's something that they used to understand with the Rocket figures, but they also confuse me in a sense, because when you have a figure like this, this figure is much smaller than this one. It is quite a bit smaller. You can see that. But this figure is chock full of articulation and this one isn't. And now the price has gone up, the amount of accessories has gone down, and the overall value for money that you feel like you're getting, that a lot of collectors feel like they're getting, is less. But anyways, going into the figure, so we got, I believe it's an all new body here. I can take down the old one, but this really is an all new body. You can still see the line going through that I've talked about on the Guardians figures in this wave. Can see the really nice detailing here. These figures don't have a lot of texturing around the chest, but they do have some detailing in terms of like the line work. You can see it's very faint in the light going over towards the arms. I like the way that this is engineered. You can actually get some really good range out of those arms, and the arms do go about 90 degrees, not exactly 90 degrees. Got some texturing there on the arm again, black line, as you can see. I am impressed with the fact that they're able to maintain the design hallmarks of the suits, of the shared costumes on these. Again, as I've said before, I don't really like, in real life, I hate matching outfits. Like, again, when you get to the head on this figure, though, Rocket has seen some crap, hasn't he? This man looks like he's been to hell and back. Now, when you look at it in real life, or when you look at it in person, you will be able to see. You got like a red around the eyes, man. It looks like he's being poisoned. Let me get Another rocket head sculpt. Okay, so this is the Cosmic Rewind rocket, and moving from left to right, you can really see, yeah, the eyes have sort of always been an issue on rocket figures now I'm thinking about it. I don't know why it's so much more accentuated on this figure, but yeah, no, those eyes are weird looking. I don't know how Rocket's eyes are supposed to look. Actually, let me just go to the box right here. Well, Rocket's eyes, yeah, they are sort of that orangish, to be fair. This just doesn't look like Rocket. They've never gotten a really good Rocket head sculpt. I've never seen anybody do a 3D printed, custom painted version of one, though. So this is kind of the best that you got. And the figure is good. The figure is good. I bet if you try to do some head swaps, like I like this Rocket head. If you try to do some head swaps, it might look pretty good. Accentuated. Matter of fact, let me just do that real quick. Yeah, you see, that doesn't look bad. The head fits on there a little bit loose, but it looks pretty good. So, yeah, this Rocket head sculpt is not great, the one that came with this figure, but at least the figure looks pretty good. I really do like the figure, to be fair, but value for money, Hasbro. Come on now. Come on now. Feels so weird to hold a big figure again. Anyways, here's Drax. Dave Bautista's Drax, aka Dead Man Walking. So what we got here is, in a sense, the same sort of Drax figures that we've seen in the past, except, well, I mean, from the legs down, from the waist up, it is pretty new. We got pinless arms here, pinless joints. You got a nice large chest. This is definitely not, when I was taking a look at the promo images, I was thinking that this figure had the same exact chest as Star-Lord. This is definitely a different chest. It's much larger, much thicker, much more Draxy. So that's what we got going on here. The figure only comes with two accessories and the Cosmo piece. It comes with one of Cosmos. It's going to be so difficult to figure out which ones are the legs and which ones are the paws or whatever. Anyways, the figure itself is really cool. I really like this. Like, it's about the same exact costume as the other ones. This is sort of our last one of the costumed up Guardians, but it's a really good figure. I really do like it. So, yeah. Coming up towards the chest, you can see same exact design cues we've been seeing earlier. We got, these are the same legs as the past version. They have pins in them, as you can see down there. So you don't got that same pinless aesthetic as the arms have. Would I rather have pinless arms or pinless legs? It's situational, but most of the time I choose pinless legs. So yeah, that's why, like, this Star-Lord figure, if his legs were pinless, man, that would have been awesome. But the Drax here, yeah, no interchangeable arms, no fists, unfortunately. But, you know, Drax is, he's cool. He's a nice figure. I can see a lot of people picking this one up because Drax figures are hard to come by. Ever since that Cosmic Rewind set sold out, and, you know, the past two Guardians Draxes are pretty difficult to come by, to be honest. Probably the hardest one to find is the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 version with the screaming head. I don't even have that one. It would have been nice if this figure came with the rocket launcher that one had, you know, even if he doesn't really use it in the movie. It would have been nice, but let's take a look at the full team together. So we got, here we go. I don't have the deluxe Groot yet, but there you sort of got to look at what you got going on with these guys. Really, really beautiful head sculpts. Really beautiful head sculpts. Like, coming around. Yeah, that's great. That's great. Let me try to take one more comparison with him next to the old Drax. Yeah, all right. That is definitely a new head sculpt. At first, I was confused on whether or not that head sculpt was reused or not. Yeah, it's a much better Dave Bautista head sculpt, man. I really have not appreciated it until now. I was really thinking that it was a similar head sculpt that we had seen before. Nah, that is new and that is beautiful. That's new, right? Yeah, no, that's definitely new. Yeah, no, that's a lot better. This looks like Drax, but it doesn't really look like Dave Bautista Drax. You know what I'm saying? That's Drax right there. Sean Gunn's Kraglin. So this figure is weird. It's, you're reusing a lot of Yondu parts. It's mainly Yondu parts. These legs are definitely Yondu's, at least. The arm might be new. These arms might be new, but I'm pretty sure that these are from Yondu as well or whatever. This figure is weird in the sense that, okay, it's proportioned weirdly on its own. You know, you can see the legs look sort of really skinny compared to the rest of the body. Sean Gunn is not, I don't feel like he's especially lanky. I could be wrong. But the weirdness of this figure comes in when you open this figure, right, and you get it in hand. You're going to notice it's surprisingly large. And you don't really realize how large until you have it standing next to the rest of the Guardians. Like, this figure really seems like a freaking giant. Like, this is like almost Marvel Select scaling. Sean Gunn is 6 feet tall. Chris Pratt is 6'2". This figure, the Chris Pratt figure, should be taller. It's almost like they proportioned Sean Gunn like he was an Asgardian. Maybe he goes through something in the film that stretches him out. Maybe he goes through something in the film that makes him taller. But this is weird. It's weird. The head sculpt looks good, though, to be fair. There's the only thing that's really new about the figure that I can tell that I've definitely never seen before is the torso. Maybe it's a long torso? Because, like, the legs about the same height? Yeah, the legs are about the same height. This figure just has a long freaking torso. Like, it's his body down. He is a very long body. Like, maybe I'm... Is it... Yeah, no, that's just supposed to be like that. That's so weird. Anyway, so he's got that. Comes with a little knife, and he comes with the Yaka arrow. The Yaka arrow is the same one that came with Yondu. It has the same curvature and everything, so it's not like a new mold or anything like that, but... Damn, why is he so tall? No, nah, Yondu is nowhere near that height. What happened? Why is this figure so tall? Guys, I'm telling you, I'm really confused. And the legs on this figure are not the exact same as Yondu's. It's like they're the same, except they're like scaled up. They seem bigger. But it's really the torso. This torso is what's doing it. This torso even looked long to me in the promo shots, but... Damn, I did not think that the figure was going to be this crazy looking. Like, why is it so tall? In person, there's something about Mantis that's really reminding me of Robert Pattinson. But here we got Kraglin. Adam Warlock, baby. There's nothing quite like opening up a figure and seeing all new tooling. This Will Poulter Adam Warlock figure I have really been looking forward to. I really think it looks absolutely magnificent. The figure itself is definitely gold, and over camera it sort of looks like a greenish sort of gold, but really in person it looks like a fine, really nice looking gold. It really just looks like they splattered gold makeup all over these sovereign aliens. So yeah, but Will Poulter's figure looks really good. I really like this Adam Warlock here is finally being introduced into Marvel. Going into the suit in detail. I got a lot of really nice tooling went into this. So starting from the boots down here, this is 100% new sculpt. I truly do believe that it is. Oh my gosh, you got that nice detailing up into the legs, coming around to the back. You got sculpt and texture all over this guy. That's something that they always do really good. Whenever they really put their mind to it, they can really have these. Damn, you can even feel those lines right there. Oh my gosh, this figure is in the running for top 10 of the year. Already. Now, to be fair, I've only gotten 8 figures this year, 9. I guess that's enough. All these figures are technically in top 10 of the year so far. If you're counting just based off of stuff that you only have. But, yeah, no, this is cool. Why isn't his chest facing straight? Okay. Yeah, moving up here to the head and the face. Got some really nice looking arms. Like, I really do like the mixture of red and gold. At first, I thought that it clashed a little bit when I looked at the figure, but... I like this. I don't have much to say about Adam Warlock. I don't know his history. Oh, well, I mean, Aisha's making him. I can tell you guys that much. And shoot, if you guys saw that trailer, damn. It looked like he punched the hell out of her. Like, it looked like she was on the ground. Maybe that was just a camera trick. Maybe he wasn't actually punching her for real. But, bro, he hit the hell out of that girl. So, yeah, there you got them there. That looks pretty good. I like that together. I really do like, these are the only unique sculpts in the wave. At least the only new sculpts in the wave, 100%. Oh, besides Rocket, of course, and the dog. So never mind, what the hell am I talking about? But two unique sculpts that I'm really happy about. I love these bodies. Here we got him next to a figure he really does remind me of, Paul Bettany's Vision. It really is shorter than the Adam Warlock figure, which is another conflict we got with proportions because Will Poulter is 6'2". And Paul Bettany is 6'3". Anyway, fact of the matter, yeah, this wave is one of the most oddly proportioned waves I've ever seen. It's so crazy. But yeah, this is cool. Really, when I saw this Adam Warlock figure, I thought that it was going to be tiny. I can't even lie to you. I thought that it was going to be small or really not small, not tiny, but you know, like regular size, if not maybe just a little bit shorter. I did not actually think that Will Poulter was 6'2", but this figure is also kind of proportioned incorrectly a little bit as well. But that looks good. I like that. For some reason, Vision really does remind me of, or Adam a Warlock really does remind me of Vision, especially this design form. You've got the little teeny tiny detailing dots. You can see the detailing on Adam Warlock's suit, though. Little teeny tiny textures are so much more minuscule than Vision's, but you can definitely still feel them. And I just love that, man. The texturing is beautiful, man. You got him there, and that's cool. Let's do one more.
Is Will Poulter next to Brie Larson.
Captain Marvel next to Adam Warlock. That's more like what I wanted to see. I'm acting like I wanted to see the two actors side by side. I like this. I really do like this Adam Warlock figure. I'm interested to see what he looks like next to some of the other more powerful beings that we know about in Marvel. And it's nice to see this comparison. I don't know. I just really like Captain Marvel's suit. Like, more especially the Endgame version. I like the design of that suit. You know what I'm trying to say? But there you go. You got Adam Warlock. Lastly, let's take a look at all of the single release figures in the wave, and then we'll build that dog. Beautiful. This looks good. This looks good. So, Cosmo, a character that made her first appearance in the first Guardians of the Galaxy, right? It's crazy to believe that we're getting a figure of her now. I mean, she's not a character that has ever really had any sort of mainstay or really big stage in any sort of MCU film. She's sort of been more like a cameo piece more than anything. And but you know, in the Guardians of the Galaxy holiday special, we actually get to see and hear her. And yeah, I'm excited to see her in the film. It's funny to see that she's actually a mainstay of the Guardians team, or at least now she seems to be. I wonder how she was recruited, but it's a cool figure. Honestly, it's a larger figure than I thought. The rocket really makes Cosmo look huge. It is a regular sized dog. At first I thought that it was a small dog. And let me just say, I don't know anything about dogs. So when I go into this figure, don't expect me to be the most knowledgeable speaking about it. But it's just a dog in an astronaut suit, which I love. That's the type of stuff that you get with Marvel. You can see here you got, again, some more nice details. Not much texturing on this figure, but you do have crinkles and seams for all throughout the figure here. To model detail, you got that gold latch painted in a little bit. It's cool. It's cool. And you got a good amount of articulation with this figure as well. Yeah, it's the gravity sort of makes it look like the hair is pointed down. So this is the way you're more supposed to have the tail posed. But really, you got a swivel here. You can point it up, point it down. It's got a little bit of a hinge back there. So you can get some good stuff going on with it. The legs do have some pretty good range. There's a way to tell which legs they are. This leg is the back leg. Okay, I just made it sound so dumb. What is actually happening is that these are not exactly all the same. You know, you got this one back here where the thigh meat, I'm gonna say, is a bit thicker than the front of the leg, the front legs. So that's how you sort of know. And then from there on, it's just the ball peg, which way the ball peg is facing, but from there, yeah, it's a really cool looking figure. Got some good articulation up in the legs. So I think all of the ankles have at least a certain amount of pivot. Yeah, all the ankles have a certain amount of pivot there. So that's cool. You got nice out on both sets of legs. And coming in towards the head, the most confusing thing about this figure actually was how to get the dome piece on there. But it actually starts to make sense. There's a peg system over there, and you can have this top dome move a little bit. I don't think you're supposed to. It sort of clicks in place like that, but if you wanted to, you could have it move like that. I don't know what the hell that thing is supposed to be. That's cool. This is a nice dog figure, man. I like this. Should it have been the Build-A-Figure? Absolutely not. This should have been one of the single release figures with a Rocket, a double release figure for $24.99, and have that be the non-Build-A-Figure thing, and have Star-Lord come with some more. Which, speaking of which, right, for me to just accentuate on that, this whole wave, right? When you got all the figures with the accessories that you want them to come with, this is all that you're going to have left over, more or less. It might not be this. It might be, you know, the hand or Nebula's sword with this. But if you have all the figures posed with their weapons, those are the only accessories you got left over from the wave. This is one of the least accessory bearing waves I've ever seen. Probably the least. So this is Cosmic Rewind Gamora. Gamora's about the same height as the other women in this wave. And yeah, it's cool looking. Hopefully we do get some sort of Volume 3 version of Gamora. Or if, you know, Gamora figures are hard to come by. If you don't have one of the Guardians of the Galaxy versions, they've only released it about 2 times. But if you don't have one of those, then you can get the What If Armored Gamora, depending on how that figure looks. I mean, it's probably gonna have that animated style as the rest of the What If figures. But if you need a Gamora and you need an MCU Gamora, that's just a variant MCU Gamora, so you can go with that. But I do like this wave. Let's get it up onto the shelf and see how it looks, and I'm gonna take a look at some final thoughts. There's Cosmo, sort of next to the Collector, by the way. The Collector's about to fall, so I can't really arrange him so that y'all can see him today. But the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 movie wave, final thoughts. These are rough poses. I'll change this up soon. But number one, the days of the smaller Build-A-Figures are not 100% behind us. Cosmo is a bit bigger than you'd expect, most likely. You know, the promo images do make him out to be a pretty small dog. He's not that little, but he's definitely not. He's probably less plastic than a regular figure here. So the days of small Build-A-Figures are not over, and some people are very alarmed about that. I'm personally, like, my view on Build-A-Figures is they're more of a bonus to the wave, so I'm not super duper hurt if they're lacking, but it would be nice to get the large Build-A-Figures back. Second thing, accessories in this wave is very concerning. The value for money does seem to be going down with the accessories. There seem to be a lot less accessories. This is probably the first wave, Marvel Legends wave, in recent history with no interchangeable hands, which is crazy. And the third thing is more of a personal issue, but my cosmic display is reaching a very critical juncture. You can start to see figures starting to get a little bit hidden. We got Thor behind there. I'll work on these poses so that I can pose them a bit more efficiently on, like, space-wise. But yeah, no, this is not good. We are running out of space. But other than that, it's a nice movie wave. Drax, I will give a 6 out of 10. Rocket gets of. The figure, the presentation of the figure gets a 5 out of 10, but the figure alone gets a 6 or a 7. Nebula is an 8, maybe a 9, 8.5. Star-Lord is a 7. Mantis here is an 8. And we got Cosmo to build a figure as the figure alone, 8.5. The presentation, I'd give a 5, honestly. As a Build-A-Figure, that's kind of corny. But tell me, guys, what you think about the Guardians of the Galaxy movie wave. I'm really looking forward to this movie. There's been a lot of character work put into the Guardians over the course of their many films, and I love sci-fi, so I'm super duper looking forward to this. And tell me, you guys, what is your most anticipated character seeing in this film, seeing and returning? And I'll catch you all in the next one. Kraglin, oh, my bad, I forgot to rate Kraglin. Kraglin is like a 5. Okay, thank you guys so much for watching. Always remember to be the best, and I'll catch you all next time.